Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today, I'll be sharing a special project with you. This project demonstrates rendering over 10,000 units on screen using Godot and Bevy's ECS system. It supports features like RVO avoidance, target seeking, and real-time combat. Without further ado, let's dive straight into the demo. Recently, I've been searching for a solution to handle massive on-screen units in Godot. However, achieving this goal has proven challenging due to the performance limitations of GDS script, a dynamically typed scripting language, and Godot's relatively underpowered physics engine. I also scoured the internet for related videos and articles, but there aren't many mature solutions. That's when I thought of Bevy. I had briefly experimented with this game engine before and was aware of its impressive performance. So, I started exploring the possibility of integrating Godot with Bevy. For those unfamiliar with Bevy and ECS, Bevy is a data-driven game engine written in Rust based on the ECS architecture. What is ECS? ECS stands for Entity Component System, a highly decoupled architecture that efficiently handles large-scale dynamic objects. Compared to traditional OOP or Godot's node composition, ECS has two core advantages. First, compact component storage for better cache performance. In an ECS system, all components of the same type, e.g., position velocity, are stored in linear arrays. This eliminates memory fragmentation between objects and makes the component layout more compact. Because data is stored in contiguous memory blocks, it reduces the overhead of random memory access. Modern CPUs have a key performance feature. They load contiguous memory chunks into the CPU cache for processing. With ECS storing components of the same type together, accessing one component often means nearby components are already in the cache, significantly boosting processing speed. Second, Bevy's ECS system natively supports for parallel task scheduling. Bevy's ECS system breaks logic into systems, enabling multi-threaded scheduling. Each system handles a specific type of logic, such as updating positions or detecting collisions. Tasks are designed to be independent, avoiding lock contention and resource conflicts between threads. Bevy has a built-in scheduler that automatically analyzes dependencies between systems. For instance, if one system updates positions and another handles combat logic, they can run simultaneously on separate threads. If dependencies exist, such as updating speed before updating position, the scheduler ensures the tasks execute in the correct order. Why combine Godot and Bevy? You might wonder, since Bevy is a game engine, why use it alongside Godot? The reason is that Godot and Bevy each have strengths and weaknesses. Godot excels in areas like graphics rendering, scene editing and UI, tasks that benefit from intuitive editing tools. However, Bevy lacks an editor, but excels in handling complex logic for large numbers of units and performance optimization. By combining the two, I can use Godot for rendering, UI, and animations, while Bevy efficiently manages the state and behavior of all units. Godot handles all rendering tasks in this project, while all non-rendering logic is processed in Bevy's ECS system. I've set the physics frame rate in Godot's project settings to 1, meaning the project doesn't rely on Godot's physics system. Of course, this approach comes with challenges, such as the complexity of Rust and pitfalls with Godot Rust bindings. For instance, I encountered an issue with the mutable borrow checker. This limitation can make certain features difficult to implement for those new to Rust. Another challenge is that I only use Bevy's ECS module, not its full plugin system managed through Bevy's app instance. As a result, I've had to implement all the logic myself. While using existing Bevy plugins is possible, I haven't explored that option in depth. After processing physics behaviors and AI logic through the ECS system, rendering becomes the bottleneck. In scenarios with over 10,000 units, rendering is the most significant performance constraint. Godot's traditional node system, such as animated sprite 2D, is easy to use, but becomes inefficient as the number of units increases. This is where MultiMeshInstance provides an efficient solution. MultiMesh Instance is a specialized node in Godot designed to efficiently render large numbers of identical or similar objects. It leverages GPU instancing to render multiple instances in a single draw call instead of rendering them one by one, drastically reducing rendering overhead. For a scene with over 10,000 units, using Animated Sprite 2D to render each unit individually would be nearly impossible to run smoothly. In contrast, MultiMesh Instance can handle this effortlessly. While MultiMesh Instance significantly improves rendering efficiency, the project's bottleneck still lies in rendering. Managing 10,000 plus QoS units is well within the ECS system's capabilities. That's all for this video. Feel free to comment if you have any questions or spot inaccuracies. Please like, subscribe, and share if you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.